you need to have some kind of a standard reference material. Then only you can compare your things. So more precisely, how we can understand this? See, if you look at it this way. So you, first of all, if you look at it, it is high accuracy is high precision. See, you have to prove it. You should know that. You maybe go to the market. You want to sell your coal. Another thing, you know that you have made that thing, you have machine or you have bought some jeweler, but that may not, that balance is accurate or not, you don't know that part. So you have to subsequently check with the other part. Okay? And third balance. Then you take the mean and then you some conclusion you come to that one. This is the true value of the your code. But this also may not be correct. Ultimately, where you have to go, you have to go to the some place which is internationally acceptable. For that, you have to, so for that, there is an international treaty, I shall be going into this one. So NMI, these are globally accepted. This is called the National Measurement Institute. They are called the primary standard traceable to the SIR. So that is, then when you go over there, then you find out how accurate is your substance which you are going on. Second one, you can see this is deviated from this one. This is a low accuracy, the high precision. They are focused to this one. And third, and then ultimately, finally, you see that all are random directions. Low accuracy, and the low precision. This is what is happening. And this is only possible when you do have some standard reference material traceable to some measurement institute. So, how this one? How this? 1875, there was to have the uniform global trade. See, if you look at it, this French Revolution, we can see the French treaty also. In 1875, there was a meter convention signed by the 17 countries that are not here. India was not independent. 17 countries, Europe and some Latin American countries, they were there. They signed a treaty, and then they should have this deadlock at the time. Britain had different system, French had different system, India also, if you look at it, here safety, Lugram, so on and so forth were there at that time. And then until you have the same uniform measurement system, you cannot have any kind of trade, any kind of. So the convention that time, they decided that we need to go for SI, International Convention on the SI system. And this is, it has a two kind of a thing. One is a diplomatic, another is scientific. And this convention, when it was signed by this thing, it is called the General Conference on Weights and Measures. It meets every 4 years. And this one, down one is the scientific and technical one. It has a CSIR, International Committee for Weights and Measures. And what do you look at it here? Because this treaty is signed by the President of India, heads of the states. Because it directly concerned with the trade with the other nation. Okay, and then the government and member directly they are connected to the National Meteorology Institute, which is the NPL, National Physical Laboratory of this country. There. And then here we do have, and the consultative committee and group committee, they are there, they keep on advising to CGPM. So that means recently, 20th of May 2019, we have the redefinition of the SIR. Now, earlier this NPL was the custodian of the weight set, for platinum, rhodium, 1 kilogram weight is kept in the NPL, the custodian, NPL director is the custodian. So, that treaty now all, no artifact thing, all these weights now, all 7 base units, now directly they are realized through the physical constant, natural constant, Planck's constant. We have now no artifact now at this today. And these are the three, if you look at the extreme left here, these are the 7 base units here. And then so there are some derived units without special names, volume, area and velocity, and acceleration, and the rest of the units, they are derived forms. And they are somehow or other, you do any measurement there, somehow it has to link to this, ultimately to this one. This is what we call the traceability. Traceability means NPL maintains all extremes, all 7 base units, kilogram to the candela down here. And from the suppose for example, we look at it here, the electric charge, directly it should link to the somehow second, and then second it should link. considering hardness, force and hardness, if you look at it here, Newton, and then it has to acceleration. Ultimately, all these units, these are maintained by the atmosphere, and this would link it, and we are linked to the BIP of France, and we are this, your measurement, whatever measurement you do, it is directly connected to the international level. So, first slide, if you see this, once you measure the atmosphere, it is accepted anywhere in the world. And this is, you know very well how you need this one. If you look at it here in the top, and the NMI NPL here, if you see, if you have two manufacturers there, one is in India and one is another one in Germany, how we ensure that? See, if you look at it where you have the milligram or microgram pills and pharmaceutical pills are there. So how we ensure that? If you export, if you have, because potency, it changes with the weight. When the potency changes, then your doses are varying. So doses are varying, it's not acceptable either. So ultimately, once you are this way, this pyramid is complete, then you are acceptable to so how it, how does it do it? See, the green one part, if you can look it in here, they are for the this one, ISO guideline, 34 guideline, you will be seeing. And then 35 for the preparation. All your equipment should be traceable to your SI units. And then 15, there are number of documents. There are not these three documents. Then ultimately you have to be at par with that. And then ultimately go to the RAMCO database. Then you are signed with the associated uncertainty. This is the international one certification procedure there. And then ultimately it goes to the certification. It is the level of available in the market. So this is the ISO guideline 17025. What is signed? Clause 6.1.1 is saying that. Recently, ISO 17025, 78 has come in the, now. We are all NPL, earlier it was 2005, now 17 is there. Level 3 is established and maintain metrological traceability, offers a measurement standard and measuring equipment by means of an unbroken chain of calibration or comparison, linking them to the relevant primary standards. Primary standard is where? Primary standard is NPL. Or you go to the other country, NMI, you go to the USA, you can do it in your country, but you can link to the PDP Germany, you can do it. Go to the NPL UK, you can go to anywhere you want. But since we are in NPL, we are in this country developing some standard, so it should be linked to the National Physical Laboratory. So then ultimately when this part is there, NAMCO I am talking about, so when the reference materials are produced, that has to be, it has to be sold out. It has to be sold out. This is for the COMAR data. So any user anywhere in the world, he looks at it one. Whatever the reference material or BNP you develop. So this is the direct link. User can interact with them and this is the complete flow chart. Then they can look at it and they can buy this thing to make their equipment traceable to their NMI. So as on today, if you look at it, this is the same data, the data I have taken from some website. So, achieve better healthcare, I told you already, certified reference materials are very, very essential for the quality assurance and the health. So, if you look at it, the pie chart here, as on today, we are something 400, this is not this, something 400 crore rupees CRMs we are buying from the abroad. All whatever equipment we buy in our country, we need to have the certified perspective. Whether it is from pharmaceutical, whether it is any scientific equipment or any steel, gold, whatever it is, their consumer product. So we need to have. Now this is the time that we need to develop these BNDs in our country. As of today, CNN produced by the NIST USA 13,500. He produces. He does it so or through the outreach or mark or they are also approaching us now. They are also coming to us. We are tying up. We have started signing MOUs with those people. And then the European 2000 and 1000 India. So in this direction now recently we have signed an MOU with the Ministry of Commerce have now understood it. Earlier they were not concerned. Now the way things are moving, when we talk about the trillion dollar economy now when we are talking, the Prime Minister talks about it. Trillion dollar economy, it will never come like just by then. You have to develop your standard materials. Okay, and gradually you need to go. I am from the CSIR, our DG CSIR recently we had a video conference. Now CSIR is also going to focus only on two things. One is the rural development. We have to go and do the rural, how to affect the rural people life. And second, monitor import substitution. How to cut that. And to improve the quality infrastructure, we need to improve the, we need to develop a large number of certified reference engineers in our country. Taking all these stakeholders into confidence and all RFPs into consideration, and then we have a large kind of a network to develop. So, need for certified reference material, what it does? It providing traceability to the SI unit, which is compatible anywhere, acceptable anywhere in the world. Then you have assigning of the value to another material. Then validation of laboratory method developed or non-standard test method. Many times our RFP, they follow the BIS standard method. So our team goes there and then validates them. And quality control check, we do it, verification of accuracy of result. And calibration of the student. NPL does lots of chemical. If you are, many a time we are going there to their side. The larger, very heavy machinery which cannot come to NPL, yeah, railway industry, yeah, NTPC, we go there and calibrate their equipment over there also. And proficiency testing and inter laboratory comparison. So with this one, we started some of the BAP at our own and some with the RFP. So far 1 year only we have seen financial. For example, we have the Cement Research Institute in Pallavgarh. We have then ASPI technology for the water all water PMC develops different concentration of this thing. Then we have the petroleum product we have. And recently we have BPCL also we assigned and one or two artists manufacturer also come. Soon we are going to sign an MOU with the IITR, toxicology laboratory, and one or two, many are now approaching there because government is also concerned that quality DND should be spread in the market, Indian market and abroad also. Because some of these DND now gone to the African countries also, we are exporting also. First it is gradually, I think it will take time in coming years that DND will be globally. As of today, you go to anywhere, we talk about it, it's a distressable. Usually this is the wording, everyone say that, is it a distressable or what? But it's not the right wording. It should be SI traceable through NIST. Okay, similarly SI traceable to NPL India it should come, then it goes there in the market. And then again traceability, we have how the NPL does the traceability of your samples, milligram per kilogram, then you have the solution and the metric bin. Then you have the gravimetry, tritometry, then you have C6M, APFP, comparison we do it, that will be linked to that. And then we have metrology, chemistry product, that we through that we also. Ultimately, we reach to the primary standard. And this is one of, since we have started now this program, BAP. So directly, suppose for example, cement industry or HP petroleum industry. So what we do, whatever we do have at HPL, we do at our own. Or then we go to their site and check them. So this is what we have. Facility available at CSIR and HPL, then we move on to support the IoT strategy. Then we move here, CSIR and HPL will establish facility with this mechanism. You can look at it here. Our team go there and check their method, are they doing correct, they are following certain guidelines, things are there, their methods are correct, all the equipment, measurement, they are correct or not, methods, whatever is given to them is correct or not, then we validate at their site. So this is the ISO DC229 nanotechnology. So this is the nanotechnology, we all know that, this is less than 100 nanometer. And DC229 has 4, 5 now we have, earlier there was only 4 groups, working groups. Now, ours comes in the working group for material specification. This is our project was on that. And then this is the document, liquid suspension of magnetic nanoparticles, ISO PS19807. The scope of this document is, this document specifies the characteristic of magnetic nano suspension to be measured, and this is the measurement method for measuring these characteristics. This is the scope of this one. Okay, and this is a generic document. Rest of the document on the magnetic will follow this. So, just for your seeing this, I am saying it's a liquid suspension of the magnetic nanoparticle. We have the 10 nanometer size particle, and when large number density of these particles, there are chances that they agglomerate and sediment out. To keep them always in suspension, you have to make some kind of a coating in this one. So, you put the surfactant. Any kind of surfactant which would be compatible, I'll not take much time. So this is the surfactant, this is the surfactant down there, and you see that this is the one. Magnetic particles always used for various purposes, but ours is the last one. Here in the histogram is there. See, damper, sensor, micro, even fine polishing, they are, because nanotubes are there, wherever the fine polishing are there, there is no other way. You have to insert the liquid there because it has the ability to polish it there. It's a huge market. So we had, before we went to this developing this document, not only because ISO, what it does, ISO, we say that we are the people initiator of the project. Ultimately, whole entire world works for you. So European Union, they have the nanoman mega project, they have done their market survey. Some billion dollar market for this product. So they have done it, and we have moved on to this one. So basically, this is the basic concept of it. Happened to the magnetic ratio, it should be always greater than 1. That has to be counted. This one, any bank manufacturers, if developing this one, he has to follow these things. And then gravitational, the magnetic energy should be always less than 1. And these are the forces, attractive and the repulsive forces, counterbalance of these two particles. Counterbalance. How you counterbalance? Then you have to water walls and the magnetic dipole-dipole interaction. This surfactant chain which is there, which makes it's like a cushion. When the particle comes through the dipole-dipole interaction, they separate it out. So this is the art, so state of art developing this kind of a thing. So for this, the document is prepared. And again, I tell you that when you have the particle, then anisotropy and safe, these are the things, they do play a role. And then the magnetic dead layer also, when you come to the finite size, then dead layer is non-magnetic layer. Non-magnetic layer means you are compromising with the properties of the magnetic part. That has to be taken into it. It's a deep science in this. To develop a nanomagnetic particle required for your specification. You can vary the stoichiometry, you can have a different RMK cobalt, there are whatever you want. You can modify your particles. Stoichiometry, well, you can choose the particles, you can choose the suspension, you can choose the curie temperature of your materials.